This is our fourth meeting. What we talk about English for business, business English at work. This is of the meaning for English for business itself. For the first, business English at work, English for business at work. Jadi bahasa Inggris urusan dalam pekerjaan gitu. Work has become more solitary with computers. Jadi itu yang teman-teman bisnis digital, yang bisnis digital major use English, use computers when learning everything subject, all of subject from this computer itself. Jadi di computers itu sendiri adalah menggunakan using English. Yes, alat bahasa yang digunakan adalah bahasa Inggris. So, work has become more solitary with computer. Jadi, antara jurusannya as a business digital major dengan mata kuliah bahasa Inggris bisnis itu nyambung gitu. Solid. Jadi ada hubungannya gitu. Karena berurusan dengan computer dan computer itu menggunakan Inggris. But sometime in practicing itself when you use a tool as a, like a computer and then the computer has languages language, sorry, not languages, and then like one language, only this English. So, you have to know more about English itself. Yes? Jadi, mau nggak mau, kita harus tahu banyak tentang bahasa Inggris itu sendiri. Walaupun sebenarnya, in a practicing, I know anak-anak komputer ini paham, ya. Cuma, so hard to practice. Jadi, sangat, hanya saja sulit untuk mempraktekannya. Membalas conversation atau question atau yes, memberikan giving the answer from the question itself. Tapi pada dasarnya in basically mereka tuh paham gitu, understand gitu. Kemudian importance of business English, pentingnya itu bahasa Inggris. English for business ini adalah bahwa di dalam lingkup pekerjaan dan keseharian kita menggunakan alat seperti komputer itu didukung dengan bahasa Inggrisnya. Kemudian, business leverage. One of the reason why people fail in business is failure in knowing the basic which communication business English. In addition, business English means respect. Respect for the person you are talking to and respect for the business. Having the command of the English language give you an advantage. Jadi, okay. So, you know, satu alasan kenapa orang itu gagal dalam berurusan di masa depan, ya, basic communication-nya in business English-nya. Jadi, English for business itu means respect. Jadi kita merespek terhadap orang yang berbicara dengan kita. Karena ya tadi saya bilang sebelum-sebelumnya pada video pertama, penjelasan pertama, ya pertemuan pertama bahwasanya English for Business adalah untuk mensupport our job, untuk mensupport pekerjaan kita. Especially you are from business digital marketing yang menggunakan computer as a tool and a computer support with English language. Nah, kita harus tahu, we have to practice, I mean. So, you have to practice because practice is a communication. Practicing is a communication. Komunikasi adalah mempraktekkan adalah komunikasi. Komunikasi, communication is a tool. Komunikasi adalah alat itu sendiri. Oke, baik. Kemudian career growth. Jadi pertumbuhan karirnya, knowledge of business English sama dengan confidence, ya. In turn, confidence might turn into good performance. Intelligence does not really put you up the corporate ladders. You need confidence to back you up, and business English provides you that, knowing that nothing will go wrong as you present in front of the people, you are sure to get a photo. Jadi, pertumbuhan karirnya atau perkembangan karirnya itu knowledge of business English sama dengan confidence. Jadi when we have to practice English, mau ketika kita when we talk English, bahasa adalah alat komunikasi. English as a tool of communication between we are and a big boss. Sometimes he was from another country and use English as his or her language. So we have to confident to practice this. Jadi, but we need a habit lah ya. Kata kita harus mempunyai kebiasaan. Without habit, we can't. Tanpa habit tuh, tanpa kebiasaan kita tidak bisa. Maksudnya not confident. When we do our habit in practice English little bit lah ya, or in general our conversation, daily conversation on general, secara umum, percakapan secara umum itu, bahwasanya itulah yang merupakan habit dan kita akan terbiasa dengan English kita and we got self confidence, kita perlu percaya diri gitu. Jadi dengan confident tadi kita percaya diri dengan performa kita. Intelligent does not really put you up because great leader is confident to back you up. Jadi untuk back up kita adalah confident kita. Walaupun kita tuh punya kemampuan intelligent yang mungkin kita tuh bisa, but without habit kita never practice, kita akan so hard to do it. Jadi akan sangat sulit untuk dilakukan karena back up kita sebenarnya adalah our self confidence itself. In English for business, so business English provides you that. Jadi bahasa Inggris bisnis ini adalah mempersiapkan itu semua. Maksud saya, ketika kita mengadakan pertemuan offline nanti, I need you can practice it about well, I will give you some topic and then you have to practice it and or present it in front of us as your client ya. Anggap aja kita ini adalah klien. Begitu. Nanti akan dikasih tahu untuk topik presentation-nya seperti apa. Okay, knowing that nothing. The internet ya, of course. Sekarang itu internet apa-apa internet ya. Jadi when we talk the internet, majority of web content is written in English. We all know that the internet is an essential part of a business. It's hard to filter goods and contents from the internet. What gives you an edge is the manner your item is written or done. Having business English in those contents means that there is something to say and there is substance to be said. Jadi the internet itself, majority of web content is written in English ya. Jadi konten pun ditulis di dalam bahasa Inggris. We all know that the internet is an essential part. Kita tahu ya, internet sekarang jaringan network itu adalah yang paling penting ya di dalam setiap urusan kita. Ya, apapun untuk belajar, ya, untuk mencari referensi, untuk membaca, bisa mencari referensi, belajar, berbisnis, berteman, connection each other, linkage, building the linkage, membangun sebuah jaringan pun we need internet. So that's why internet as a backup to us of when we want to practice or to make one habit in our daily life to practice English. Sometimes internet is help us to support how to spell it well. You know that? I give you Cambridge Dictionary as a recommended dictionary to learn English as well. And there is so you can choose what is the action what you want to say. But sometimes there is two kind of action. You can choose one of the best that you can do it, that you can understand well. And then one point is we use US. So you have to follow it well. Jadi lakukanlah bagaimanapun caranya. Internet mensupport kita untuk semua hal. Mungkin sampai sini for the our fourth meeting ya. You have any question before our offline at 11th and 12th our offline meeting. So before that, we have to talk each other. We have to discuss each other about the English for business itself. That how the internet is a back of you to make you like do one habit in practicing for English. Or you will know about the English as well, how to spell it well. Internet.